remember those distant days, those of you that probably most of you don't remember, but long before, you know, there was a time when there wasn't an internet. There was no Facebook. There was nothing like that. If you want, and there was no tellies. And before there was any tellies, if you wanted to find out what was going on in the world, other than what was happening in North Shields or Bog's End, you had to go to the news cinema. And the best one was up here. The Tyneside Cinema is in that same building now, the wonderful Tyneside Cinema. But that was built by a man called Dixon Scott in the 1920s. And it was opened as a news cinema. And that's where you went to if you wanted to find out what was going on. We're not going up that way because of it, but you can just see the sign for it up there. Dixon Scott, you might recognise the name. Cinema, Scott, that sounds familiar.
Ridley?
His nephew is Ridley Scott, and the other nephew is Tony Scott from South Shields. So it's obviously in the genes. Go and see things there, it's fantastic. It's well worth it. Right now, imagine you were in a band in the 1960s. In a group. They called them groups then, they weren't bands. And you're doing quite well, you know, you're doing all right. People are coming to see you, you still look like variety show type things, but you're doing all right. You've had a couple of records in the charts, they've done quite well, and people think they're going to like what you're doing. And your manager rings you up and says, we need a new single in a fortnight's time. They used to put them out about every 3 months, you know, new single. We need a new single. And they said, well, we've been gigging, we haven't had a chance to write anything. He says, well, you're going to have to write something in the studio next week. He says, oh, bugger. Right, okay. So we'll not go to the nightclub after the show, we'll just go back to the room. So they went back to the room after the show and they got their guitars out and they sat down and started writing a song. And they thought it was cunning, you know, it didn't take them long, you know. I mean, usually wrote their songs fairly quickly, but they wrote it in probably about an hour. And there was no tape recorders then, not portable, you know, so they just had to remember it in their heads and they went down the following week. Well, and recorded it, and it was quite successful. Well, the place this band were touring was, they were in Newcastle. And the hotel they were in was called the Royal Turk's Head, down there on the right. And the song that they wrote that night, and that came out a few weeks later, was this one. Enough of them. They're from Liverpool, you know, and that's all they talk about when you go there. We've got loads of things. All they had was the Beatles and Cilla Black, you know. Much as I like that.